Andromeda, mythology. In Greek mythology, Andromeda, Greek, Nu Delta Rho Omicron Mu Delta Alpha, Andromeda or Nu Delta Rho Omicron Mu Delta Eta, Andromeda, is the daughter of the Ethiopian king Cepheus and his wife Cassiopeia. When Cassiopeia's hubris leads her to boast that Andromeda is more beautiful than the Nereids, Poseidon sends the sea monster Cetus to ravage Andromeda as divine punishment. Andromeda is chained to a rock as a sacrifice to save the monster, but is saved from death by Perseus. Her name is the Latinized form of the Greek, Andromeda, or Andromed, ruler of men, from Aner, Andros, man, and Medon, ruler. As a subject, Andromeda has been popular in art since classical times. It is one of several Greek myths of a Greek hero's rescue of the intended victim of an archaic hieroscamos, sacred marriage, giving rise to the princess and dragon motif. From the Renaissance, interest revived in the original story, typically as derived from Ovid's account. In Greek mythology, Andromeda was the daughter of Cepheus and Cassiopeia, king and queen of the African kingdom of Ethiopia. Her mother Cassiopeia boasted that her daughter was more beautiful than the Nereids, the nymph daughters of the sea god Nereus and often seen accompanying Poseidon. To punish the queen for her arrogance, Poseidon, brother to Zeus and god of the sea, sent a sea monster named Cetus to ravage the coast of Ethiopia, including the kingdom of the vain queen. The desperate king consulted the oracle of Apollo, who announced that no respite would be found until the king sacrificed his daughter, Andromeda, to the monster. Stripped naked, she was chained to a rock on the coast. Perseus was returning from having slain the Gorgon, Medusa. After he happened upon the chained Andromeda, he approached Cetus while invisible, for he was wearing Hades's helm, and killed the sea monster. He set Andromeda free, and married her in spite of her having been previously promised to her uncle Phineas. At the wedding, a quarrel took place between the rivals, and Phineas was turned to stone by the sight of the Gorgon's head. Andromeda followed her husband, first to his native island of Seriphos, where he rescued his mother Danae, and then to Turins in Argos. Together, they became the ancestors of the family of the Perseidae through the line of their son Perseus. Perseus and Andromeda had 7 sons: Perseus, Alcaeus, Helios, Mestor, Sthenelus, Electrion, and Cinyrus, as well as 2 daughters, Autoctone and Gergophany. Their descendants ruled Mycenae from Electrion down to Eurystheus, after whom Atreus attained the kingdom, and would also include the great hero Heracles. According to this mythology, Perseus is the ancestor of the Persians. At the port city of Jaffa, today part of Tel Aviv, an outcrop of rocks near the harbor has been associated with the place of Andromeda's chaining and rescue by the traveler Pausanias, the geographer Strabo, and the historian of the Jews Josephus. After Andromeda's death, as Euripides had promised Athena at the end of his Andromeda, produced in 412 BCE, the goddess placed her among the constellations in the northern sky, near Perseus and Cassiopeia. The constellation Andromeda, so known since antiquity, is named after her. Andromeda was the daughter of the king and queen of Ethiopia, Alpha Theta Iota Omicron Pi Alpha, modern-day Ethiopia. Ethiopia roughly translates to country of burnt faces, so one might conclude that Andromeda was black. Professor Elizabeth McGrath discusses this idea in her 1992 article The Black Andromeda, based on Ovid's writings. 1. In his first work, The Aroidor Epistolae Aroidum, Epistles of the Heroines, Ovid uses the Latin word fusca to describe Andromeda, and fusca means black or brown. 2. Also in Aroid he has Sappho explained to Phaon, though I'm not pure white, Cepheus is dark slash Andromeda slash charmed Perseus with her native color dot slash white doves often choose mates of different hue slash and the parrot loves the black turtle dove. 3. In Ars Amatoria, The Art of Love, Ovid makes the following references to the daughter of the king and queen of Ethiopia. A. That Perseus found her among the black Indians. B. That in terms of attraction, nor was Andromeda's color any problem slash to her wing-footed aerial lover. C. That when it came to fashion, white suits dark girls, you looked so attractive in slash white slash Andromeda. Henry Louis Gates Jr. wrote about the black Andromeda in a 2014 article for The Root magazine. In his article, Gates points out the inaccuracies seen in the film Clash of the Titans. The original, the remake and the sequel all have Andromeda cast as a white woman, when Ovid describes her as black and both her parents wear a black. In his book Amazing Fact About the Negro, Gates has at number 68, what was the original color of the mythical beauty Andromeda, and why does it matter? The book is his homage to Joel Augustus Rogers' 100 Amazing Facts About the Negro with Complete Proof. Andromeda is represented in the northern sky by the constellation Andromeda, which contains the Andromeda Galaxy. The advancement of science and technology allowed the emergence of astrophotography, which allowed more concrete observation of the Andromeda constellation and led to the discovery that the galaxy lies within the Andromeda constellation. Four constellations are associated with a myth. Viewing the fainter stars visible to the naked eye, the constellations are rendered as. Other constellations related to the story are Sophocles and Euripides, and in more modern times, Corneille, made the story the subject of tragedies, and its incidents were represented in numerous ancient works of art, including Greek vases. Jean-Baptiste Lully's opera, Persée, also dramatizes the myth. Andromeda has been the subject of numerous ancient and modern works of art, which typically show the moment of rescue, with Andromeda usually still chained, and often naked or nearly so. Examples include, one of Titian's poesies, Wallace Collection, and compositions by Joachim Tuell, Louvre, Veronese, Bren, many versions by Rubens, Ingres, and Gustave Moreau. From the Renaissance onward, the chained nude figure of Andromeda typically was the center of interest. Rembrandt's Andromeda chained to the rocks is unusual in showing her alone, fearfully awaiting the monster. The Italian composer Salvatore Chiarino composed an hour-long operatic drama called Perseo e Andromeda in 2000. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.